Hello everyone, let's continue the chapter number 7 of your EBS from the window. Before we start the chapter, let's try to recapitulate the chapter of Omana's journey because this chapter is the continuation of the previous chapter. So in the previous chapter, we know how Omana started her journey, right? Even though she failed the plan with her friend Radha in going to Kerala, she has a nice journey alone with her family, even though Radha is left alone at her homestead. The diary recommended by Radha's mother makes her journey joyful. Whatever she has encountered in the journey, she can easily share with Radha through her diary when she returns back. In the last part of the previous chapter, they have passed through the railway station called Valsad in Gujarat. Many people were buying and selling food. Omana's family also bought some bananas and chiku through the window itself. She also met some friends. It was around 8:30 p.m. at night when Omana went to brush her teeth. There was no water and somebody said that it will be filled at the next station. That's how the Omana's journey ended in the previous chapter. Now, let's continue with the chapter number 7, From the Window. Let's read out all together. It is morning now. Last night, I went to sleep early. It was too dark to see anything from outside. When the train stopped early this morning, I woke up. It was Medgaon. That was written on the board at the platform. Appa said that we were going through the state of Goa. We got off at the station and had some hot tea and filled our water bottles. The train started again. I find it difficult to describe the scene outside. It is so beautiful. It is green everywhere, filled with red soil and green crops, hills covered with trees. Here, Omana, in this story, the time is 7:30 a.m. in the morning. Last night, Omana went to sleep early and she could not see anything from the outside as it was too dark. When the train stopped early in the morning, they had reached Medgaon. She could know the place she had reached by reading on the board at the platform. Her father had said that they were going through the state of Goa. So Medgaon is in which state? Then it is in Goa. So they have reached Goa. So they get down of the train at the station and they had hot tea and filled your water bottles also. The train is starting again. You know what Omana said? She said the scenery is so beautiful that it is very difficult for her to describe the beauty. She said that she describes that the green is everywhere because of the plants growing in the field. The fields are covered with red soil and green crops, and the hills are also covered with trees. Now, let's see the next page. Sometimes I can see small ponds and far away, behind the hills, more water. I can't make out if it is a river or the sea. The air is cooler and not so dry as in Ahmedabad. The train passed a level crossing. People are waiting on both the sides of the crossing for the train to pass. There are buses full of people, cars, trucks, auto rickshaws, cycle, motorcycle, scooter, and even tongas and bullock carts with people and goods in them. Some people do not switch off the engine of their vehicle even while waiting at the level crossing. There is a lot of smoke and noise. I see some people going under the bars of the level crossing. How dangerous this is. At times, our train crosses another train. Uni and I tried to count the carriages in one such train, but both the trains were going so fast. We always get confused. Here, from the train, she could see small ponds. You know what is a pond? Pond is a small water body, right? Many used to have it at home. she could also see more water behind the hills, which is very far, that she could not distinguish whether it is a river or a sea. In that place, the air is cooler compared to that of Ahmedabad. Okay, again, the train passed a level crossing. You know what a level crossing is? It is an intersection where a railway line crosses a road or path. Okay, many people and vehicles are waiting on both the sides of the crossing for the train to pass. So they are going to pass once the level crossing is open. The vehicles waiting for the level at the level crossing includes what types of vehicles are there? Buses full of people, cars, trucks, auto rickshaws, motorcycle, scooters, and even tongas and bullock carts with people and goods in them, right? You can see also see in the picture. People are so eager to pass the level crossing that they even don't switch off the engine of their vehicle, though they are waiting at the level crossing. Because of the traffic jam also, there is a lots of smoke and noise. Since they don't off their engine, many smoke used to come out, right? There are also some people going under bars of the level crossing. You know what? It is very dangerous. If by chance someone pushed from the back, he will die, right? So we should not be in a hurry to cross the level crossing. Okay. While they were traveling on the track, their train crosses another train sometimes. Okay. So Omana and her sister try to count the carriages in one such train, but both the trains are going so fast that they always miss the counting. So let's continue the next page. Sometimes people cross the track even when the crossing is closed. What do you feel about this? Later, I was sitting near the window with my eyes closed. Suddenly, the sound of the moving train changed. Coot, coot, coot. I opened my eyes. Guess what I saw? Our train was crossing a very big river on a very long bridge. As it was crossing the bridge, it sounded very different. The wheels rattled as there was no ground, only the tracks and the water down below. When I first looked down, I felt giddy. It was really quite scary. The river down below was full of water and had some boats. I could also see some fishermen. You know what? Sometimes even people cross the track, even though the crossing is closed. That's a very dangerous thing if we think. While they are trying to cross the track, and when the crossing is closed and the train pass by suddenly, then that person will be hit by the train and he can die. So we shouldn't try to cross it when the level crossing is closed. So it was 8:30 in the morning. In the morning, Omana was sitting near the window with her eyes closed. Then suddenly, there is a change in the sound of the moving train. It was changed to coot, coot, coot. She suddenly opened her eyes. You know what she saw? She saw that their train was crossing a very big river on a very long bridge. You know what is a bridge? A bridge is a crossover structure carrying over a road, railway, or across the river. The sound of the train changes suddenly because it was crossing the bridge. The wheels rattle, that is making a sharp sound because there was no ground and there was only tracks and the water below. When Omana looked down at the river, she felt giddy, that is feeling dizzy. She is feeling scared also. Even if it is you will also feel scared, right? The river was full of water and handsome. But she could see some fishermen too on the bank. Now let's see the next page again. I waved at them, but I did not know if they could see me. Alongside our bridge, there was another bridge for buses and cars. This was built differently from ours. I think going over our bridge was more adventurous. You know what she did to the fishermen? She waved at them. Omana waved at the fishermen. Wave means she raised her hand and moved side to side. But even though she waved to the fishermen, she did not know whether the fishermen could see her or not. On the side, Omana could see bridge. Another bridge for buses and cars. The bridge for the buses is different from that of the train. Omana thought that going over her bridge, that is the train's bridge, was more adventurous, that is more exciting. Okay, you get my point? Now let's see the next piece. The last few hours have been so exciting. After breakfast, I climbed on the upper berth to read my comics. It was bright and sunny outside. Suddenly, everything became dark. It also felt a little cold outside. Inside, I was afraid. Then, the lights in the train came on. But outside, it was very dark. Somebody said, "We have entered a tunnel. This goes right through the mountain." The tunnel seemed to go on. And then, just as suddenly, we were in daylight again. Outside, it was sunny, bright, and green. The train had crossed the tunnel. Appa explained that we were on the other side of the mountain. Since then, we have passed through four smaller tunnels. Now, I am enjoying going through the tunnel. Here, the time is just 5 minutes to 6 o'clock. The last few hours they have been very it has been very exciting for her. After taking breakfast, Omana climbed on the upper berth to read comics. Outside it was very bright, but then suddenly everything became so dark and cool. Omana was thinking what was happening. Then somebody said that they had entered a tunnel. Do you know what a tunnel is? A tunnel is a long passage under or through the ground made by people. So, Omana was also afraid that the tunnel passed through the mountain. The tunnel seemed to go on and on. Then it was daylight again after passing some time. The train has crossed the tunnel. Omana's father explained to her that they were on the other side of the mountain. Then they just passed some more tunnels, small tunnels, and now she is enjoying. She is no longer scared of passing the tunnel. Again, let's see the next piece. Now it's afternoon for lunch. Now it is afternoon. For lunch, we had idli vada that we bought from UDP station. We also bought some bananas. They were very small and very tasty. The scene outside has changed again. Now, we can see many coconut trees and green fields everywhere. Amma says that these are paddy fields. The houses and villages look very different. People's clothes are also different from what we see in Ahmedabad. Most people are wearing white or cream-colored dhotis and saris. Many people who were with us from Ahmedabad have got off. People have also got on to the train from different stations. Sunil's family is getting off at Kozhikot, which comes at around 6 o'clock. We have exchanged addresses and plan to meet in Ahmedabad. You will also like Sunil and Ann. And now the time is 12:15 p.m. afternoon. They had idli vada for lunch. It was bought from UDP station. UDP station is in Karnataka. They also bought banana, which are very small and tasty. The scene outside the train has changed again. They saw many coconut trees and green fields everywhere. Her mother told that the field is paddy field. since they have reached a new place. The houses and villages look different, and the way people dress up is also different. Most of the people are wearing white or cream colored dhotis and saris. Many of the people who board on the train from Ahmedabad got off, while many people also board on the train from different station. Sunil's Omana's friend that she met on the train are also getting off at Kozhikode, which comes around 6 o'clock. So Omana exchanged addresses and planned to meet in Ahmedabad. So she is telling Radha that she will also like Sunil and Ann. She makes a good friend with them. Now it's night. We have also started packing up. The train will reach Kottayam in about 3 hours. That is where we have to get off. Tonight we will go to Viliyamma's house. Tomorrow we will take the bus that will take us to Amuma's village. We all are quite tired. After all, we have been on the train for 2 days. What a long journey it has been. We had a lot of fun. I will put my diary away now. I will write again after we reach Amuma's house. Here, this is the last page. It was 4:45 p.m. and it's night. Now it's night for them. They have started packing up their things. They are getting off at Kottayam, which will reach within 3 hours. That night, they are staying at Valiyamma's house. Valiyamma is a Malayalam word which means mother's elder sister. So Omana is staying at her auntie's house for the night, and next day they will go to Amuma's village by bus. Amuma's means maternal grandmother. That is Omana's grandma, maternal grandmother. For now, they are all tired since they have been on the train for 2 days. Isn't it a long journey? They had a lot of fun also. Omana is saying that she is going to stop writing for the time being and will continue to write when she reaches Amuma's house. Children, isn't the diary entry of Omana's interesting? When you travel next time, you all should make a diary entry of your journey. You will cherish forever. Let's continue the next chapter when Omana reaches her grandmother's house. Thank you for today.